Seriously, kid, where are you from?
Queens.
Well, maybe it's time you went back to Queens.
There's something comforting about knowing that even the biggest stars aren't safe from embarrassing themselves sometimes.
Let's just say I was a little baby.
And when it comes to auditions, some stars have had their fair share of humiliations. From messing up in front of important directors, to embarrassing accents, failed magic tricks, and everything in between, these Hollywood stars didn't get to where they are now without falling flat a few times on the way up.
They never tell you the stories about the actors who did something mad and they're like...
Tom Holland was only 19 years old when he was cast as Marvel's new Spider-Man out of over 7,000 other young actors, which makes his audition process even more terrifying.
I can only imagine what it is you're going through.
For the very first screen test for the role, he was put opposite one of the biggest stars in the world and a personal hero, Robert Downey Jr.
It was really scary.
Look at me when you talk about me.
Tom was understandably very nervous to act with RDJ, but had proved himself to the directors by being able to actually flip into the scene over and over again.
He's flipping every take. He's flipping over and landing on his feet.
All of us cringe a little bit when we look back on our younger selves. And even a TV star like Shay Mitchell is no different. She actually only found out about her Pretty Little Liars audition the night before it was scheduled to happen, and had to practice her lines in the coat room of a waitressing job that she was working at all night.
You gotta do what you gotta do.
When she finally made the tape, it was in the basement of her agent's office, and she accidentally wore a t-shirt that was the exact same color as the green screen background.
My shirt matched the background!
Back when The Hobbit was casting roles in England, they saw just about every single British actor out there, including Eddie Redmayne. Eddie was brought in for the role of Bilbo, and apparently got so excited that he prepared just a little bit too much.
My name is Bilbo Baggins.
When the scene started, Eddie busted out a very silly Hobbit voice that he thought would be good for Bilbo, before the casting director immediately stopped him and told him to speak with a normal voice. Ouch.
I never got a callback.
It's one thing when an actor has to go into a room and make a fool of themselves in front of the director, producers, and casting directors. But what happens when they have to do it totally alone?
Let me begin by saying that there are two sides to every story.
Well, Emma Stone found out exactly how awkward that experience can be when she auditioned for Easy A. Because of scheduling conflicts, Stone wasn't actually able to be in the room for the first audition, so they had her record her own audition over webcam with no direction.
Let me just begin by saying that there are two sides to every story.
When Kat Dennings got an audition opposite an Oscar-winning male actor, she thought that it was about to be an amazing scene. But what happened in the room is a whole lot less glamorous than it sounds. In the scene, Dennings was playing the daughter of this famous actor, and was supposed to be having a complete breakdown while being held by her scene partner. But instead, the actor chose to stand at the opposite end of the room, leaving Kat there to scream and cry and comfort herself, while he read his lines off a piece of paper. That sounds beyond uncomfortable. And she didn't even get the role.
The only happy ending to that horrible story is that that actor got fired.
When he was brought into audition for The Lord of the Rings, Jake Gyllenhaal was pretty unprepared. First of all, he had no idea that he had to prepare a British accent. And when director Peter Jackson found out, he apparently called him the worst actor ever and told him to fire his agent. All of this was after Jackson tried to direct Jake during a scene where he discovers the ring in amazement. But his reaction was a little underwhelming.
So I sort of like walked up and I like sort of opened it up and I was like, is that good?
When Aaron Paul was working on Mission Impossible 3, he learned that J.J. Abrams was a fan of magic, and mentioned that he was too. Unexpectedly, J.J. dragged Paul in front of Tom Cruise and asked him to show them a trick, which totally failed.
It fails miserably, it's terrible.
To make matters worse, when Paul auditioned for Cloverfield, J.J. made Aaron tell the whole story again in front of the casting directors. It got him so flustered to relive the tale that he completely forgot his entire 3-page audition monologue, and eventually just gave up and left. That's gotta hurt. Brie Larson has always taken acting very seriously, if not a little too seriously. When she was a child actor, her first ever audition was for a fish stick commercial, and it did not go as the 7-year-old had planned. In the big group audition, the casting directors went around and asked each of the kids what their favorite thing to do was. And when they got to Brie, she, very seriously, said,
"I like to act."
When she realized that it hadn't gone well, and that they wouldn't be asking her to perform the monologue, she burst into tears.
"They didn't ask me about my monologue!"
Adam Devine's breakout role was in the a cappella comedy Pitch Perfect. But when he showed up for the audition, he had no idea that the movie involved singing. He thought it was a baseball movie.
"I swear to God I did. I honestly did."
So when he finally figured out what he was there to do, the only song that came to mind was the theme song from Full House, even though it was totally wrong for him. Oops. Back when James McAvoy wasn't a household name, he had his fair share of terrible auditions. One he remembers very clearly involved having to learn the guitar and sing for the part. But once James actually got into the room, he totally froze and forgot everything he had learned.
"And I stood in front of them and my heart was in my mouth and I just thought, I've got to get out of this."
So in order to get out of it, he actually started fake crying and pretended that his best friend had been hit by a car. In the weeks leading up to Emilia Clarke's audition for Game of Thrones, she had been trying to be in the best shape possible and totally cut out all sugary foods. But when she got to the audition, they offered her a Diet Coke, which she drank all of.
"I'm gonna take that Diet Coke, I'm gonna take that sugar."
Well, since she had been eating so clean, the Coke made her feel completely crazy. And when the producer jokingly asked if she wanted to do a dance, she did. And not just any dance, she did the robot and the funky chicken.
"Yeah. It was super intense. And it's the only move I know."
Before Chris Evans was Captain America, he auditioned for Ben Affleck's movie Gone Baby Gone. Chris didn't even have a chance to make it into the room before he started embarrassing himself. See, as he was parking his car, Ben Affleck himself called out to Evans to say hello, and the young actor got so nervous that he started babbling to Ben about whether or not he was okay to be parked in this spot.
He was like, "I think you'd be okay."
He didn't get cast, but things turned out pretty well for him anyways. Lucy Hale was very young when she was asked to audition for the 50 Shades of Grey movie. For the audition, she had to do a very explicit monologue in front of the casting directors, but she didn't even really understand most of what she was saying.
"I just was a little naive about it all."
Being so naive, Hale just wasn't aware of that kind of thing. Luckily, she didn't have to do any of the steamier scenes along with it.
"What would happen?"
Ryan Reynolds is pretty grateful that he doesn't have to audition anymore, and it must not help that his last audition ever was for two of his favorite directors, the Coen brothers.
"It wasn't the right fit, unfortunately. Mostly because they're very high class."
While we don't know what part he was up for, he went out to audition for their musical comedy Hail Caesar, and totally bombed. It's hard out there for a young actor, and that was no different for Jennifer Garner. For one of her first ever TV auditions, Jennifer thought that the appropriate thing to do was wear the same outfit for every callback, because that is what they tell you to do in the theater. Well, it wasn't the greatest idea for TV, because after wearing the same unwashed outfit for over 4 callbacks, the producers finally asked her agent if she actually owned any other clothes.
"I didn't get the job."
You know what they say, even the best fall down sometimes. No matter how big you get, everyone has to start somewhere, right? But here's hoping we never have to go through this kind of embarrassment for a job. Thanks for watching.